The following is an audio tape by the Clarence and Jerry Smith Company. If you want more audio tapes, just call 1-800-237-9322. That's 1-800-237-9322. And now, your audio tape.
Somersault. Little Miss Somersault is the sort of person who doesn't just go out for a walk. Oh no, not Little Miss Somersault. She is too full of energy for that. Rather than walking everywhere, she cartwheels everywhere. She doesn't just walk through her front door. That would be too easy. She built a house where she could climb over the roof first. Little Miss Somersault doesn't just sit in a chair. She balances on the back of it. Little Miss Somersault doesn't walk around things. She jumps right over them. And rather than answering the telephone like you or I might, she somersaults while she's doing it. The other day, when she was cartwheeling past Mr. Worry's house, he called out to her.
There's a leaf on my roof. Please could you get it for me? He asked.
Mr. Worry had spent the whole morning worrying that the leaf might make his roof fall in.
I have a long ladder, he added.
Little Miss Somersault said, I don't need a ladder. And, quick as a flash, she climbed on top of Mr. Worry's house and got the leaf off. A little further down the lane, Little Miss Somersault came to Mr. Skinny's house. Mr. Skinny was at the top of a ladder, painting his roof. Unfortunately, Mr. Bump came around the corner and walked under the ladder. Or rather, he tried to walk under the ladder. But, being Mr. Bump, he walked straight into it. Bump! And Mr. Skinny was left hanging from the roof. Little Miss Somersault had seen it all happen, and without a thought for the ladder lying on the ground, she climbed to the top of Mr. Skinny's house and carried him safely to the ground under her arm. He wasn't very heavy. The next morning, everybody had heard about Little Miss Somersault's daring deeds. The phone rang. It was Mr. Uppity.
There's an umbrella stuck up my chimney. I hear you're good at climbing onto roofs. I'll expect you here in 5 minutes.
Mr. Uppity's house is one of the biggest houses you will ever have seen.
To climb to the top of Mr. Uppity's house would be a real challenge, said Little Miss Somersault.
It took no time at all for Little Miss Somersault to climb onto Mr. Uppity's roof. Then she looked down at the ground far below her. That was the last thing she should have done. Little Miss Somersault suddenly felt dizzy. Her knees began to tremble. Everything began to spin round and round. Little Miss Somersault had discovered she was afraid of heights. Luckily, Mr. Tickle happened to be passing. He stretched out one of his extraordinarily long arms. Do you think he wanted to tickle Little Miss Somersault? Of course he did. But not before he had brought her back safely down to the ground.
Stop it!
Laughed Little Miss Somersault.
I promise I won't do anything so foolish again!
And off went Mr. Tickle to look for somebody else to tickle. That evening, Little Miss Somersault was sitting. That's right, sitting in her armchair. Suddenly, the telephone rang.
My hat has blown off, said a voice at the other end.
and it's landed on the roof of my house. Could you...
Little Miss Somersault's face turned pale. Who is this? She asked in a trembling voice.
It's Mr. Small,
said Mr. Small. Little Miss Somersault breathed a sigh of relief.
I'll be there in 5 minutes,
she said, and off she somersaulted.